is Ashwin again. How are you doing? In this video tutorial, we are going to understand what hierarchical inheritance is and how to implement that stuff in Python 3. So without wasting any time, we are going to understand the concept of hierarchical inheritance in Python. So now consider this example. Here there is a single base class, and then there are multiple children classes derived from this base class. So base class is the base class. Derived class 1, derived class 2, and derived class 3 are the children of base class. So this sort of organization of classes in classes is quite useful in multiple real life scenarios. So when we have organization of classes like this, it is known as hierarchical inheritance. So let's see what sort of real life example could have this sort of hierarchy of the classes. So if you consider the class animal, and then you consider the classes human and fish, then you will actually immediately understand the relationship between all these three types of classes. Basically, humans are also animals, fishes are also animals. Everything which are not included in the plant kingdom, or bacteria or viruses or algae and all that sort of stuff, those all things are counted as animals according to the modern biology. So humans are animals. Many conservative people would not like this proposition, but that is true. Humans are animals, as well as fishes are also animals. So now the relationship between animal, human, and fish is like humans are animals and fishes are animals. Okay, so we can have a base class known as animal, and then we can derive the classes human as well as fish from the class animal. So this sort of organization creates a hierarchy, and that sort of hierarchy is known as hierarchical inheritance in all the modern object-oriented programming languages. So not only Python, but the other programming languages like C++ and Java also feature this sort of inheritance known as hierarchical inheritance. Now let's try the code for hierarchical inheritance. Okay, so let's first create a class animal. Okay, and then let's define a method in this known as move, def move self. Okay, so let's print I move, therefore I am. Now this is a pun intended. Okay, so now next class is class human, and it is derived from class animal. So this is an animal. So this is this is derived from the class animal. And let's overwrite this method move self and print humans can walk and run. Finally, we are going to have another class known as class fish, and then it is also derived from class animal. And let's define it. Define move self print I can swim and dive. Fishes can swim and dive. Okay, so now if you closely see that the classes human and fish are derived from the class animal. Okay, and we have defined a method move. Okay, which is nothing but a behavior of almost all the animals. Okay, all the majority of animals, that most of the animals move. Okay, so we have defined it as move, and we are we have added a print statement in that. So in the class human and in class fish, we have overridden that method move, and now we are going to see how to invoke all these objects. Okay, so let's define a main method. Okay, so let's define a main method, main function, sorry, and create an object of human, h1 equal to human, h1 dot move, and f1 equal to fish. f1.move. Okay, so if name equal to main, then call the main method, call the main function. So now this is the code for creating the objects of human and fish. So we have created an object of human h1, and then we have called the method move. The same way we have created the object for fish f1, and then we have called the method move. Okay, so now h1.move and f1.move should call the move functions from the move methods from the respective classes. Okay, so now let's execute this code. Right, humans can walk and run, fishes can swim and dive. So this seems to be the correct output. Now let's have a look at like multiple scenarios in which we can use hierarchical inheritance in real life. We can say vehicles. And vehicles are two type, like automobiles and then non-automobiles. Non. Okay, so in order to explain this, I'm going to tell you about the classification of the vehicles, right? So vehicles are anything which help actually us to move from one place to another place, right? So the, there are two types of vehicles. One type of vehicle is automobile. So an automobile is something which is powered by external power, like an electricity and or by fossil fuel. And then there is something known as non-automobile, so which doesn't have any control or anything like that, and it can be powered by horse or it can be powered by human, like a horse-drawn cartridge and a human-drawn rickshaw. Like the vehicles like that. So further we can classify the automobiles in multiple categories, like fossil fuel powered and electric power. Okay, then we can also say coal powered. Technically, I guess fossil fuel and coal power fall under the same category. We can, so these are like pretty much the classifications of automobile. Then again, fossil fuel, we can say petrol, gasoline powered automobile, and then we can also have diesel powered. Automobiles. So electric power automobile, we can again further classify. So this way we can create the hierarchy of the stuff. So now after like looking out at all these examples, you must have understood the scenarios where we have to use hierarchical inheritance. So whenever we need to actually have categories where the parent of those categories is common, and then all those stuff derive some sort of like common attribute or some sort of common behaviors from the parent class. So in those cases, we use the hierarchical inheritance. Okay, so another example is snakes. So snakes are of two types. So venomous snakes and non-venomous snakes, or not so venomous snakes. So I have heard that most of the snakes inject some sort of venom, but most of the times that venom is like very mild or like not lethal, or it is not like very potent. So, and then we can have non-venomous snakes. So all the snakes, right, all these three types of snakes, they fall under the same category, snakes, right? So they have like some common attribute, and they have even some common behavior, right? So almost all the snakes, they crawl. So we can actually define then a couple of attributes as well as the couple of behaviors for the common category snake, and then according to the how much venom the snakes carry in their mouth or in their glands, we can then have an attribute which is going to classify the snakes based on the type of venom and the amount of venom they inject when they catch their prey or when they act in self-defense. That sort of stuff we can do with hierarchical inheritance. So this is like how pretty much hierarchical inheritance works in real life as well as in programming languages. It is not only the feature of Python, it is the feature of like all the modern object-oriented programming languages like C++ and Java. So this is what the basic of hierarchical inheritance is. Thanks a lot for watching my videos, and do not forget to subscribe to my videos, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more exciting videos on Python 3 programming. Thanks a lot.